Zohar, the Persian Splendor, is a major competition for artistic teaching. That's 19 years in the latter part of the 13th century in the geographical region in the East of Syria, in northern Spain. The word itself is derived from a Persian book of Daniel, the Hamaskidim, or Syria, the Zohar, or Syria, in Latin, the Syrian, or the Syrian, or the Hebrew. The book of the Zohar is actually not a single book, but is an anthology, a collection of various literary units. The earliest unit comprised of the Dawn of the Mediterranean, the Hidden in the Past, and it is principally written in Hebrew. And the stones are attributed to a number of rabbis who lived in the 2nd century in Palestine. With the development of the Zohar literature, they began to form a clear sense of the literary supremacy, consisting of 10 living figures from the 2nd and 3rd century Palestine, and at the head of that, therefore, a supremacy of the Havara, the Simeon and Benjamin. The noble part of the Zohar is written in Aramaic, as are the latest strata in the Zohar literature. It became especially clear in recent scholarship that the work itself is a very complex composition made up of these discrete parts. And the compositional and redactional history probably stretches way beyond the latter part of the 13th and early part of the 14th century into the 16th century when the material is being prepared for publication. However, we like to understand the genesis of the Zohar composition, whether it was written principally by one traveler, Moses Shalom, or by a circle of travelers, who was committed to the number one, one thing is certain, that by the latter part of the 16th century, the Zohar was emerging as the most important travelistic work, eventually attaining triumphal status, equivalent to the Bible and the Talmud. In fact, the Bible, the Talmud, and the Zohar were seen to become three holy works that constitute the basic purpose of the spirituality. Among time, the experiences that were described in the Zohar, that were seen by the Talmud and his mystical powers, serves as the blueprint for other problems. The study of the Zohar, these problems are able to attain the experience that the problems behind the Zohar composition is attributed to the biblical figures and also to the Egyptian answers. So, this is where the opinions of these problems are expressed.